Welcome to Everyday Cooking. Today we'll do a pasta and white sauce made with whole wheat flour. Take 2 cups of pasta. To this add about 2 cups of water. Add required salt. And pressure cook this for 2 or 3 whistles. Pressure cooking will make this very soft. If you want, you can simply boil this in water. Now add 1 teaspoon of butter in a pan. To this we are going to add a cup of mixed vegetables chopped. We have taken carrots, beans and capsicum. You can add cauliflower, cabbages and even green peas and even sweet corn too. Now we'll saute all these veggies. Add some salt to it. Saute this for around 5 minutes and set aside. Vegetables are ready now. Now we'll prepare the sauce. Add 1 tablespoon of butter to a pan. Add around 4 to 5 finely chopped garlic and a small piece of finely chopped onion to the butter and saute this well. To this add 1.5 tablespoon of whole wheat flour. Saute the flour very well. To this add 1 cup of milk little by little. No lump should be formed, so add little by little and mix very well. We are going to add fresh cream later. If you don't want to use fresh cream, just increase the whole wheat flour by 2.5 tablespoon and increase the milk by 2 cups. Even if you change these measurements, you'll be getting the similar results. To this, we are going to add 1 teaspoon of mozzarella cheese, but this is optional. If you want the dish to be cheesy, you can add this. Add 1 teaspoon of oregano and 2 teaspoons of chili flakes. If you want the dish to be spicy, you can add chili flakes more. To this add required amount of salt. Now we'll add the cooked pasta. Give a nice mix. This is almost ready now. We'll mix 1/2 cup of fresh cream to this. As I have told before, if you don't want to use fresh cream, add extra milk and whole wheat flour before itself. Now we'll give a quick mix to this. Now we will add the sauteed veggies to this. This is ready now and this tastes so good. If you want this to be cheesy, just add more and more mozzarella cheese. Adding mozzarella is purely optional. You can add as much as you want and close and cook till the mozzarella cheese melts. Now this is ready to eat. Thank you for now. We'll join you in another interesting recipe and subscribe for more videos.